Can you kindly explain on this committee? Anong provision ng PSA na kalabas na pwede tayo magkaroon ng late registration as long as this kind of situation that Mayor Alice Guan?
Go.
Have encountered 17 years, tapos niregister natin. Baka itong nangyayari ito na nangyayari sa buong Pilipinas. Kaya tayo, ang dami ng mga late registration. Oo, on the Ulysses. So sila may hawak ng system.
Corporation.
Yes, of course. Yung ang database, sila may hawak. Ulysses. Who owns Ulysses? Ulysses. Who owns Ulysses? Who owns Ulysses?
Ulysses Corporation. It is a corporation.
Who owns the corporation? What are the names of the directors, officers? Ang tagal mo na doon. You should know everything. 40 years ka na andun. And it happened. Within that 40 years, itong problema na kinakaharap ng ating bansa na marami foreigners na nalilegitimize, especially yung mga Chinese na ginagawang Pilipino. Are you a part of it? Are you a part of it? Ma'am, I'm asking you.
So, now that the LCR said that there's no record of Mr. Willie Ong, born May 29, 1977, and PSA, as you're saying now, walang birth certificate on record. Is that correct, PSA?
Your Honor, based on the registry book of the local civil registrar to my kawayan, it appears that the registry number belongs to someone else. It was registered to us because of a valid endorsement coming from the former LCR. Now, the move of the authority, the PSA, is to endorse the case to Mr. the Chair. Office of the Solicitor General for cancellation, Your Honor.
Nakakapagtaka kasi paano nangyari yun, no? Na wala naman siyang birth certificate. No? So, Congressman Fernandez.
Parang may problem tayo dito. Kasi ngayon ko lang na dinigdig yung issue that I learned from the statement of the good chairman that in the last hearing, Mr. Chair, that NCR did not issue any birth certificate. No? And according naman sa PSA, nagbase lamang po sila sa issuance ng NCR. Paano po mangyayari yun that NCR never issue any birth certificate while PSA nagbase lang po kayo sa in-issue naman ng NCR? So there must be somebody who is lying between the two of you. Have you invited the NCR, Mr. Chairman? Yung sa ating local civil registrar?
Andiyan?
Yes.
Ayan. So, wala kayong issuance, NCR?
Wala po kaming record, Your Honor.
Wala kayong record. Wala. Pero sinasabi ng PSA, nagbase sila sa in-issue ninyo. Eh, wala naman silang in-issue, attorney, PSA. How is that so?
Your Honor, we have already submitted the endorsement from the LCR.
No, that's not the question.
Your Honor, the first endorsement which we received from the LCR at that time, actually he's the one who...
How can you verify the authenticity of the documents that were submitted to you from the LCR? Kasi lahat dyan, merong mga tinatawag na security measure that is coming from the different LCR. So, do you have a mechanism of trying to find out the veracity of the transmitted documents coming from the different LCR? Baka itong nangyayari ito na nangyayari sa buong Pilipinas. Kaya tayo, ang dami ng mga late registration na nagaganap. Mr. Chairman, kasi I really don't know how many cases are there right now. So, attorney, what is the mechanism for you to find out the legitimacy of the documents coming from the LCR?
Thank you. Your Honor, we have sample specimens of the concerned LCR, Your Honor.
What again?
Signature of the LCR, Your Honor, in our database.
Signature of the head of the LCR.
Yes, Your Honor.
So, alimbawa ako, galing ako sa Santa Rosa, LCR ko, nag-sign ako, pinadala ko sa inyo. That is already legitimize, without Honor, verifying, especially when these people are foreigners. Or napapalusutan kayo sa PSA.
Your Honor, diba?
Kasi ano eh, napakasimple eh. Ito sinasabi ng NCR, wala silang in-issue, tapos sabi nyo, galing sa NCR. Kaya, most likely, have they taken their oath, Mr. Chairman?
Yes, they have.
Mukhang meron ditong kumikita ng malaki sa PSA. And I believe that this is not happening on a on one certain area. And I believe this is a protracted conspiracy. Well, it's not conspiracy, but somehow malakihan itong nangyayaring to dahil ang involved dito mga Chinese. Di ba? And we have to warn you, attorney, you are under oath, and at the same time, the stake of the national security ang pinag-uusapan dito. And you are conniving with the enemy. Dahil nililegitimize natin yung pagiging foreigners nila. Di ba? And yung reason po ninyo na pirma lang, approve na sa inyo, that is a big excuse, ha? Anybody can sign on behalf of the civil registrar. Di ba? Your mechanism of trying to find out the validity of that documents is not acceptable. Imagine, pirma lang, ikaw ko pumirma nun, dinaya ko yung pirma, tatanggapin nyo na, attorney? Answer, please answer. Coming from any other LCR, pag nakita mo may pirma na yung head, that's it.
Mr. Chair, can I just interject?
Yes.
With the indulgence of Congressman Fernandez. Yes. Yes,
attorney, kailan po kayo pumasok sa PSA?
22, Your Honor.
So 2022. Yes, and yung certification na binigay naman ng PSA is, tama ba yung date, August 31, 2001?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So is anyone from PSA here today na nagtatrabaho na po noong 2001?
Yes, good morning.
No, 2001 kasi boss yung August 31 yung ano eh, binigay, yung certification. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. So anyone from you? From
yes, we already submitted a copy of the endorsement letter coming from the local civil registrar of Mekawayan, Bulacan. During the time.
Yes, so but, yeah. But the problem here now is LCR ngayon po is denying na may record nun na may registry number na 127. Instead, ang record nila is 127-B77 and different name po yung nakalagay.
Yeah, we also checked po in our microfilm that the name of Stephanie Ong is the registry number 127 is for Stephanie Ong.
Yeah, kasi naalam lang po natin, tama po si Congressman Dan Fernandez, medyo delikado rin po to, especially kung specimen signature lang ng LCR ang binabasihan nyo, tapos magiging Filipino citizen rin po kaagad because of the late registration. And now, basing sa sinasabi po ng present LCR ngayon, they don't have any record na pinasa sa inyo noong 2001. That's why I'm asking you, attorney, to give to be fair lang po sa inyo because this happened 2001 and just assumed office 2022. Kaya po nakita ko po yung itsura nyong nagugulat po kayo, no? So, ang inaalam lang po natin is ano ba yung mga security measures kasi ayaw na po rin natin maulit din po ito.
Yes, sir. This time po, we are strengthening po yung process of delay registration. Meron po kaming drafted na memorandum regarding this. Based din po sa mga suggestion na we need to require the late registrant to appear.
Yes, but ito na po yung case natin ngayon. Sinasabi po ng LCR, walang record sila regarding the Willie Ong. So, ano na po ang remedy natin sa PSA ngayon regarding the status of the citizenship of Willie Ong na nag-late registration na wala naman po talaga na record, nag-emanate doon po sa ating LCR.
Okay. Your Honor, with regard to your question, we have already drafted an endorsement letter to OSG for the filing of cancellation of the birth certificate of Willie Ong.
But aside from that, Mr. Chair, if I may, no? Well, I'm really sorry, no? Bago ka lang pala doon. I really don't know. And that was issued on 2001 pa. May we possibly know kapag nanggaling sa NCR yung dokumento, what part of your agency received that document?
actually may division of concern on the receipt and control.
Na tanong ko lang, anong part ng inyong ahensya ng PSA ang tumatanggap ng dokumento na galing doon sa LCR, sa Local Civil Registrar? Syempre nagpapadala yan ng dokumento, di ba? Sino tumatanggap doon?
PSA.
Hindi nga, anong part ng PSA? PSA no, is
anong division? Civil Registration. Ha? Civil Registration Division.
Civil
Registration Division.
Sila tumatanggap ng mga birth certificate na dinadala noong mga applicant.
No.
Sila.
No po. Registration at the Local Civil Registry level.
O nga, di ba? So, okay, sa local, di ba? So sinasabi nyo, dinadala pa sa inyo, meron din kayong kopya, di ba?
Yes.
Sino doon sa PSA ang tumatanggap ng kopya ng galing sa Civil Registrar?
Sa provincial statistics office muna po 'yun.
So provincial statistics office sa provincia muna.
Opo,
sa and then dadalhin sa national.
Yes. They provide po the copy for the PSA.
So in other words, it's more of a ministerial job on the part of the PSA yung galing sa Local Civil Registrar. Is that what you are trying to imply with us, to us?
Yes, the PSA is the national repository of the documents.
Depository lang kayo?
Yes.
So in other words, lahat na nakukuha na dokumento, eh paano to? Wala nga in-issue ang NCR eh. And then suddenly, meron sa PSA eh. Paano nangyari yon? So depository lang kayo? So much more na, Mr. Chairman, the yes, more sir. That we have to investigate this matter. Because what we can see in here is somehow, doon sa PSA mismo, merong isang division dyan na nag-aayos ng mga dokumentong to na peke. Madam, I'm not pointing at you. Kaya huwag kang mag-anta dito. Huwag kang mag-react. Because if you reacted this way, eh baka kasama ka. How long have you been in the PSA?
Actually, almost 40 years.
Ilan?
40 years.
40 years?
Since NSO days.
40 years.
NSO time pa.
Ang tagal mo na doon. You should know everything. 40 years ka na andon. And it happened. Within that 40 years, itong problema na kinakaharap ng ating bansa na maraming foreigners na nalilegitimize, especially yung mga Chinese na ginagawang Pilipino. Are you a part of it? Are you a part of it? Ma'am, I'm asking you. Are you a part of it?
Definitely no.
Hindi kasi nga ma'am, sinasabi ko po eh, depository lang kayo eh, sabi nyo. Kung depository lamang kayo, yung mga dokumento na nanggagaling sa mga LCR, tinatanggap nyo lang. Para kayong isang system, para kayong interface, na pagkatapos na magawa na ng LCR yung kanilang mga dokumento, meron lamang kayong kopya. Depository nga lang eh. Pero unfortunately, in here, nakikita natin, wala silang in-issue, kayo meron. How is that so? There must be a problem in you. Kaya Mr. Chairman, lumalawak yung problema natin dito sa mga foreigners na legitimize. What part of your provision, of your policy that involves the, what do you call this? The provision of yung late registration. Anong parte ng inyong provision na pinapayagan nyo ang late registration? Like for the example of Mayor Alice Guan, 17 years, saka lang siya na-register. How is that so? Why did you allow it? Can you kindly explain on this committee? Anong provision ng PSA na kalabas na pwede tayo magkaroon ng late registration as long as this kind of situation that Mayor Alice Guan
go.
Have encountered 17 years tapos niregister natin? Correct, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Siguro 40 years ka doon, nasa PSA ka na. Have you encountered this issue of Alice Go? Late registration? Ano po yung policy po natin sa late registration?
Meron po kami procedure on the late registration. Actually, we consider po na timely ang registration within kapag na-register siya within 30 days.
Within?
Upon birth po. Dapat na i-register siya in 30 days po. So we consider that timely. If na,
so no matter how long you've been in the country, kahit na 30 years ka na, pwede ka pa rin mag-late registration. Is that the policy?
Meron pong late registration procedure na dapat i-comply po nila. Yung
can you kindly give us the provision of your policy on the late registration? So wala siyang capture na time element. Na for example, kailangan hanggang 5 years ka lang.
O, sa ngayon po, wala pong Basta after ng reglementary period, if talaga magre-register po, yun po yung consider na delayed registration.
So, who is the head of that ano, of that registrar na nag-upload noong mga documents coming from the LCR? Sinong head sa PSA?
Sa ngayon po, meron kaming civil registration service.
Na sino nga po ang head?
Si Assistant National Statistician Marisa Grande.
Ilang taon na po siya doon?
Hindi ko.
Sir, Mr. Chairman, can we invite that that person from the PSA as well? Because we need to find out the culpability of our government agencies that deal with the approval of the PSA, you know? Kasi nakikita natin dito, baka malaki itong sitwasyon na to, Mr. Chairman. And that's the reason why we wanted to invite those people who are responsible for receiving the copies coming from the LCR. Tignan po natin yung sino ang mga ito. At especially sa province ng ano? Sa
Kanagaling? May Kawayan.
May Kawayan, Bulacan. Sila yung depository. Sino yung head ng depository nyo? We need to invite them, Mr. Chairman, to shed light on this matter. Kasi ano, kitang-kita po natin na may problema doon sa ano, transmission eh. Kung depository lamang sila, dapat talagang magre-reflect lang kung ano nang gagaling sa mga civil registrar. Pero kung meron ngayon nakakasingit, ang problema nasa PSA. Depository, nasa inyong problema.
Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Fernandez. Just in relation to, before I recognize Congressman Atop, in relation to the question raised by Congressman Fernandez, and before that, I'd like to acknowledge pala the presence of Congressman Gaston Buting. Welcome to the Committee on Dangerous Drugs.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Good morning po sa inyo.
So, from LCR, papunta sa PSA, wala bang kasamang mga supporting documents yun?
Yung submission po ng mga requirements po ay nasa local civil registry offices po.
And when the LCR submits to endorses to PSA, anong kasama dun sa endorsement?
Yung transmittal lang po.
Transmittal lang? Walang ibang documents that would support the transmittal?
Yung file po is nasa local civil registry offices po.
Okay, thank you. Congressman Akop, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I know from Madam Roque, you also attended the last hearing, right?
Hindi po ako nakarating nung May 8, Your Honor.
The previous hearing?
Hindi pa po.
First time mo?
Apo.
So, you are certifying that there is no record of Mr. Willie Ong's birth insofar as your office is concerned?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Thank you. Now, PSA, are you aware of a document dated 27 August 2001 from the Office of the Civil Registrar General regarding the request of Mr. Willie Ong for travel abroad? He was requesting for certain from your office files for his birth record. Are you aware of that?
Your Honor, we have po a copy of the certificate.
Tinatanong ko lang, ma'am, kung you're aware of it.
Yes.
And would you say that this is authentic muna?
Yes.
Yes. And what does it say?
Certifying that the birth record of Willie Ong alleged to have been born on 29 May 1977 in Mikawayan, Bulacan had negative results.
Had negative results. Yes. Pakibasa ulit. Pakituloy nyo para marinig ng ating ibang mga kasamahan.
This is further certifies that civil registry records of births for the year 1977 are intact in the files of the Office of the Local Civil Registrar, the above them locality as per status report of civil registry records submitted to this office on 14 May 1999.
Go ahead, ma'am.
Further, verification may therefore be requested in the files of that office.
Now, you are certifying that pursuant to your record, kasi National Statistics Office document to, di ba?
Yes.
The precursor of your office now, the PSA. Tama po?
Opo.
Yes. And therefore, pursuant to your records, wala pong ka-record si Mr. Willie Ong.
Yes po.
Yes. That is dated 27 August 2001. Tama?
Yes.
Now, let's go to another document from the Office of the Municipal Civil Registrar dated August 31, 2001, 4 days after
Are you aware of this, the local civil registrar? It was signed by a certain Mr. Epifanio Areno.
We have a copy, po, sir.
You have a copy of that?
Yes.
And what does this document say? 4 days after the PSA certified, na wala silang records regarding the birth of Mr. William.
Sir, the office of the municipal civil registrar, Mr. Epifanio Areno, has endorsed the copy of the document on 31st August 2001.
So yes, this is an endorsement. Tingnan mo, Iha. Yung date ng PSA is August
27.
August 27, right?
Yes.
Tama?
Yes, sir.
Yun yung kwan ng PSA. Pero yung document ng na walang record si Mr. William. Tama? Pero sa local civil registrar, dated August 31, 2001, ang date of birth ni Mr. William ay May 29, 1977. Tama?
Yes, boss.
Oh, paano nangyari yun? Sinasabi ng PSA, wala ka silang records of birth. Dated August 27, 2001. Pero 4 days thereafter, nag-issue ng document ang local civil register August 31, 2001. Nagkaroon na kagad siya ng birth date.
Sir, may process po tayo ng endorsement if with negative result from PSA. If positive po or may kopya at the local civil registrar, may process po tayo ng endorsement na tinatawag. So this one po is endorsed by the local
civil registrar. Hindi, ang sabi kanina ng local civil registrar, wala nga silang record of birth ni Mr. Willie Ong. First, next question, paano nagkaroon ngayon ng dokumento ang municipal civil registrar August 31, 2001, meron ng birth date si Mr. Willie Ong? Hindi nyo ba naintindihan yung impossibility ng mga ginagawa ninyo? Ha? Nahuhuli kayo doon sa ginagawa ninyo eh. Oh. Kasasabi lang ng local civil registrar to the queries of the Honorable Dan Fernandez kanina na wala ngang record ng birth ni Mr. Willie Ong doon sa LCR. Sinertify din nyo August 27 na wala ngang record, pero magic, nagkaroon. Turuan nyo nga po kami na paano mag-magic ng ganyan.
Your Honor, the reason why we have the record, because it was validly endorsed to us by the then local civil registrar. We have here the original document, the endorsement letter, dated August 31. This is an original document, Your Honor, bearing the specific signature of the LCR. When we receive this, we verify it with
our... Who is the LCR then?
Mr. Epifanio Areno.
Kaya nga, yun nga sinasabi ko, nag-issue kayo ng certification August 27. Walang record si Mr. Willie Ong.
Your Honor,
tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, teka, tatapusin mo ako. Do you agree with that? Ha?
Yes, Your Honor, we confirm the document.
Yun lang ang gusto ko marinig. Huwag mo nang dagdagan. Dahil baka lalo kang lulubog. Tapos sabi ng local civil registrar, wala silang ka-record. Madam local civil registrar, eh bakit meron po kayong, meron pirma yung inyong dating civil registrar, si Mr. Epifanio Areno, na merong birth date si Mr. Willie Ong?
Your Honor, hindi ko po siya masagot kung paano po nangyari yun that time. Pero anong time na po yun? Wala nga po. Wala po kami nito. Wala po kami.
Ito yung dokumento eh. Oh, binabasa ko. Tapos sasabihin yung wala. Sabihin naman ng PSA. Meron noong 2001. Alam niyo? Kung titingnan po natin ito, ordinaryo lang ang tingin nyo na problema nito eh. Pero may implications po ito. Ginagawa nyong kalokohan. You know, any alien can get a Filipino passport. And I think it is already happening. If we have a DFA representative here, yes, I think nangyayari na po ito, di po ba? Yes. Noon, very reliable yung data ng DFA regarding birth dates of individuals, lalong-lalo na kung may passport. Ngayon, di na ako naniniwala pag ganito ang nangyayari. You could just imagine yung value ng passports natin ay bababa in so far as the eyes of other countries are concerned. You can ask DFA about that. Ganun ang nangyayari. Yun ang impact. Napakamura ang ating passport. And you, the agencies concerned, doon nag-originate kung paano in-issuean ng passport ng DFA yung isang alien. That is why sinasabi nila rito na merong national security aspect itong problemang ito. So, paano nyo i-explain yung mga ito? Ha? Paano? And the PSA, in the last meeting, you committed to form a technical working group to look into this problem. Tama? I have it on record. PSA was directed to create a technical working group to study this issue. Are you aware of that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. And your report must be submitted, according to this, to be submitted to the committee before the SONA of the President in July 22.
We submit, Your Honor. We will draft.
You better do that.
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Chair. Congressman Akop. Before I acknowledge Congressman Fernandez, let me acknowledge first the presence of our Senior Deputy Speaker, Congressman Dong Gonzales of the 2nd District, 3rd District of Pampanga. Welcome to the committee hearing of the Committee on Dangerous Drugs.
Thank you,
Mr. Chair. Congressman, a while ago I was asking the that we invite the pinaka depository department of the PSA, including all those who are manning the sa computer, yung mga
database.
Na database, kasi merong may head case diyan, eh, di ba, ma'am? Ma'am, Thelma Kahanding, you've been there for 40 years. Nasa national kayo?
Yes.
National kayo, right? So kung sa national kayo, alam niyo kung sino yung head nung nagmaman nung database. Sino, anong pangalan ng nagmaman ng database?
Actually, we have po a partnership
with a private entity?
Yung computerization po ng PSA is a PPP project.
Ano po? PPP project? Yung ating mga documents ng ating mga tao with regards sa birth certificate, death certificate, private
yung computer,
partnership?
Yung
anong company kayo mayroong PPP?
With Ulysses po.
Ha?
Ulysses? Ulysses Marine.
Yung Ulysses na yon is being owned by whom?
A private...
Who owned the Ulysses? So sila may hawak ng system?
No, corporation.
Yes, of course. Yung ang database, sila may hawak, Ulysses. Who owns Ulysses? Ulysses, who owns Ulysses? Who owns Ulysses?
Ulysses Corporation. It is a corporation.
Who owns the corporation? What are the names of the directors, officers?
We will be given a time, sufficient time to verify with
this the central office. Yeah, okay. Sige, we will give you time. But what I'm asking is the person who negotiated with PSA. Siyempre, yung may-ari nung yung Ulysses ba? Ulysses.
Yes,
o siyempre, nakipag-negotiate yun sa inyo. Anong pangalan niya? Baka mamaya foreigner yan. Eh, nababenta na yung ating mga records. Anong pangalan po nung pinaka-presidente ng Ulysses?
Deng Xiaoping.
Can you kindly submit to us, kung nahirapan po kayo, submit to us all the names of the directors of the UNICEF. And how long had been how long have we been in contract with them? Ilan taon na po tayong may kontrata sa kanila?
We submit, Your Honor.
Sige po. Okay. Can we invite also Mr. Chairman yung si yung pinaka-head ng PSA si Dennis Mapa and also that the last three former PSA officials, okay. Mr. Chairman. So, and also all those who are manning the database of the PSA. Okay. Yung controlling mismo ha, yung nagko-control ng pagpasok noong mga nanggagaling sa iba't ibang local civil registrar. We need that, Mr. Chairman.
Simply, because I have 110 million reasons to start with. Such